What's up everyone, Dr.D here, and in this video we're breaking down, wow, I never thought I'd see this day. We are breaking down Dead End Groove Radar Special Challenge. Yeah, the one and only, the notorious Degrees. Yeah, I never heard anyone say that until like just yesterday, but we are breaking it down. We're going to do our best, and I was going to do it yesterday or the day before, but I needed it to be on left, because whenever I play this song, I always play it on left. I do know I will make a lot of notes throughout this entire video, because the Dead End Groove Radar Special is, like I said, it's notorious throughout the DDR community. It's well known as like a joke chart. No one really took it serious. No one thought it would be PFC'd. People made bold claims early on that no one's going to PFC it, and then all of a sudden, like within the last 3 years, like four or five people got it. It's kind of insane. There's like Brazani, there's Hibiki, there's Matt, Little Matt, there's Chris, obviously, and even Hudson. I believe Kaze573 got it. Yeah, it was so funny because like in 2016, 17, like everyone's like, who's gonna get it? Who's gonna get it? A lot of people were close, but yeah, it took so long for to finally happen. But anyways, what happened is throughout those, I mentioned those because most of those people, they were doing it on shuffle. Yes, in fact, I think all of them except Hibiki PFC'd it on shuffle, so it's almost impossible for them to give you a breakdown. They can, like, or their breakdown would have to take hours and hours because there are so many different shuffle patterns. And I know that near the end, Kaze573, he really was able to recognize what kind of charts he was getting just by looking at some of the opening sequences. So shuffle is a different beast, and a lot of people do recommend that if you want to get your best score, you should throw it on shuffle, because eventually you're going to get a pretty good pattern that's going to give you the whatever score you're looking for. Just, it's like rolling the dice. And unfortunately, if you're like me, stamina is an issue, and you can't afford to just keep rolling the dice 15 times in a row, because our body just can't take that. Okay, I'm getting old, I'm getting up there in age, so it's not going to work out for us. But if you're younger, well, go for it. Just keep rolling that dice on shuffle until you get the pattern that you're going for. So with all that out of the way, it's important to know that when I'm going to be breaking down this chart, I am not breaking down a way that you're ever going to be getting a PFC on it. There are definitely parts where I'm going to suggest either bracketing or kind of BSing and stuff like that, so do not be using this breakdown if you are trying to PFC it or even GFC it, because it's unlikely you're going to get it through what I'm going to teach you. Now, if you're just trying to look for a way to maximize your score and get consistent results, maybe this is up your alley, because I have studied the chart on left quite a bit. There was one part of my my DDR career that I did look at it pretty seriously, and I did a breakdown just solely, just going through it on left and like trying to find out all the secrets and tips and tricks on how I can maximize my score while still getting a consistent pattern that's better than the original pattern. And I think I found that. So I'm going to share that with you today. I hope you find it helpful. I hope you can get a PB by watching this. And yeah, okay. So we're going to dive right into it. And we're going to start, as always, with the BPM. It really starts at 96 BPM? That can't be right. Yeah, I guess it's 95 because it goes to 190, and then at the very end it's going to be at 380. And that brings up the first point. The first point is going to be the speed mods, and oh boy, you don't have a lot of fucking options here. So I will just say that whatever you can read it at right now, always try to bump it up and bump it up and bump it up, because that's going to help you. Even though the 380 part is going to be pretty brutal to read, well, I'll tell you this, while I'm talking right now, the 380 part is pretty much already finished. So in other words, it's really relatively short. And with that being so short, the majority of the points that you're going to be able to get are all here. And all of this is at either 95 or 190. So you're going to want to be able to get the most points here while you can. And there's a lot of methods back here that you can have some memorization, some muscle memory, and you can still kind of bracket and get a lot of points near the end. And if you know the ending is just jumps, then you're good. So yeah, just keep that in mind. So you should be more focused on this. I'm not saying ignore the ending, you can't, but if you're just going for like score and trying to get a better score, the higher speed that you can get this earlier section on, the better you're going to be. Alright, is that clear? Okay, good. Let's make sure we're at 60, and we're going to go. And this song features one of my most hated pet peeves in DDR. The first step is on the first sound, just like OTP. Don't you love that? There's absolutely no fucking, like, okay, I'm not going to get started, but yeah, and for speed mods, we got 1.5 here, which we'll be looking at mostly, but most of you are going to be reading it something closer over here, like on 3x, but the ending should be unreadable, unless you're superhuman like Chris. Alright, so first note is on the first step, or first sound is on the first note. Alright, and we're hitting that note with the right. So this whole section, we are going to be keeping our right foot on the up arrow center, so our right foot is hovering over up right, and our left foot is hovering over left down. And I do drop the hold for this one. You can still get the okay by dropping it and going at the last second. And very keen observers would know that this is actually already suffering from blue note syndrome. This red note, the quarter note, that's actually an eighth note. That's an eighth note. Yeah, there's a lot of like blue note, yellow note syndrome going on throughout this entire chart. So keep that in mind. Like, do you really think that like these all should be starting on yellows? Like, no, it's not. This is yellow note syndrome, okay? There's a lot of this. I talked a lot about blue note, yellow note syndrome in my new decade challenge breakdown. So check out that breakdown if you want to know more about that. I'm going to gloss over that here. All right, so keep that in mind that there's a lot of syndrome going on here. So it's kind of like mentally, if you kind of want to like erase all of your like preconceived ideas, try playing it on flat. Play it on flat a few times. It should kind of wipe clean your impression of what things should be, and you can focus more on what they are. Alright, so keep the foot position, drop the foot, hit this one, and we're hitting this with our left, and once again drop it and hit it. Okay, now this part we can play it out. I always hit this with my right toe, and then I heel toe down here, and for good measure I actually like lift up on my right foot, and during this note I'll hit back down. So I actually do 1, 2. So I do 1. I don't just completely drop it like that, because there's a chance you'll get an NG here, but if you do 1 and then 2, and then you should be good. And then we're gonna do the reverse right here. Oh, by the way, I'll show you another method that you can do that. I've been able to do this, but if you want a safer method, I'll tell you right after mine. And then left heel, do the same thing. And then right one more time, and do the same thing. And then left and up. Okay, the alternative method that you can do is start with the left foot, left, right, and then 1, and then ghost foot switch down here. So left foot, left foot, and then right foot. Foot switch here with your left foot, right foot, left, right. But no matter which way you choose to do, you have to do this now. As you're in this position with your right foot on the up arrow, during the freeze, you have to jump and switch to your left foot. And we're going to count out, because we're going to have a 1, 1, 2, 3 immediately. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's a 4 count. It's a 4 count, and during the 4 count, so 1, 2, 3, 4, we're going to be switching our positioning so we can get our left foot on the up arrow. And then for all of these, we're going to be putting our left foot back to the top. And then this one's the right foot. And then this one, I do a foot switch. So as soon as I hit this, 1, 2, 3, I hit my left foot down here, and then my right foot is already in position to hit this, And then we're going to do the opposite of the earlier pattern with down. And then we're going to do this. And then if we're doing mirrored versions, then we're doing again. So during here, we're going to foot switch our left foot up to here. And now we're in position to do the down crosses. So one, two, three. These are hard. Believe it or not, it's actually not as hard as a New Decade Challenge. I referenced New Decade Challenge already, and here's the second reference it's going to get. There's a lot of patterns similar to this, so I'm going to once again strongly encourage you to take a look at my New Decade Challenge breakdown, because a lot of the patterns, like these down crosses, are featured there, and I tell you how to do them. And this is even slower. This is a slower speed, so surprisingly, technically, it's easier. It might look harder because the speed is slower to read, but physically it is easier. So pay attention to that. So I'm going to gloss over these just a little bit. So, and then this one, we are finishing with a right here, and we're going to use our right to get this. Now this is like probably like one of the awkwardest things. So if we did that with crossover, what we just did was we did right, left, right. Now our right foot is on the left arrow. I will now, with my right foot still on the right arrow, I will foot switch. I'm not sure if switch is the right word, but I will bring my left foot and join it on to the left arrow. So one, two, three, my left foot comes and joins, and then I'm ready to use my right foot over here. And now we're going to do the same thing, but on the ups. So this time we're going to be facing left, and we're going to do back crosses. So left foot to that, and then left foot to that. And then I do a hop here. Now, if it's not a perfect mirror, because this plays out differently than what just happened above. But what I do, as soon as I finish with my left foot here, I kind of like hop. I think I might use the center panel with my left foot to get my positioning back, but then I use my right foot to hit the 1, 1, 2, 3, and then we're finishing here with our right foot, and that's awkward, so we're going to do the same thing as before. Our right foot is here, our left foot around this point is going to come to join it to hold it down to finish the freeze, while our right foot is going to come back over here to the right arrow. Okay, and then okay, now we're, that was pretty simple comparatively, so now we're gonna go on. So what do you guys think so far? Is this tickling you? Damn. Yeah, I hate that feeling, even though I haven't played DDR for a while. Yeah, so we're getting into this. Alright, so let's continue. So we're holding it. And now this part I double step. I absolutely double step this entire thing, including this, which is a tough double step because we're doing four with the right foot. Hey, full screen, hello. We're going to do four with the right foot. So one, two, three, four, all with the right foot. And then I should do this, but I don't. I'm going to be honest with you. I actually hit this with my left and hit this with my left, and then I have to swing my left all the way up here to get this. Don't be like me. You should use this arrow to do your double step to the down. So get your right foot down here, and right foot down here, so then you're positioned here, and then we can play that one out. And now this is like really hard shit, but you're gonna have to do it twice. So once you hit that, we're gonna get these two lefts, and then we have a down and then a down triplet into that. How the hell do we do that? If you're paying attention, you should know that our right foot is here right now, but we have this. We're not gonna hit this with our right, not a chance. So what we're really going to do, we're gonna do the triplet, and then we're going to hop and foot switch with our left, so we can get our left foot to start here. And then we're going to do the triplet. And then once again, we're going to have to do a foot switch. So left here, up with our right, and then left foot here. So we have to foot switch once again. So as soon as we hit this, we foot switch our left foot to come to the top and finish it. And then this final section before we have like a little bit of a... it's going to do it one more time, but then we'll have a little bit of a break. This part, I bracket this step. So we're holding down with our left here. I hit my right heel here, and then I slap down both my left down and the left, left, well, left, my left foot, I hit the down and the left, so I lift up briefly and I slam it down so I can finish the freeze, and then with the right foot, and then we're going to do the foot switching one more time here, so make sure after this area we're with our right foot, and then here's the foot switch, so left, and then foot switch with your right, and then one more time, left, and then foot switch with your right. And then once again, this is a little bit more important. And this whole section up here, it's going to go contrary to what you would want to do, which is always hit freeze, up, down freezes with your right foot on the top. Don't do that. We always want to make sure that we are left foot on the top for the next ones. But you can actually get away with hitting it here first. I will hit this with my right foot, but then I'll immediately do a switch. But anyways, to finish this pattern, so we're here now. Left foot. We'll hit this. Right foot will do a jump here, so I'll briefly lift up and make this a jump so that we can finish the freeze smoothly. And then we hit that, and then I hit the freeze. And as soon as I hit the freeze, I jump. So, dun dun. So, think of it like an up-down jump followed by an up-right jump. However, that up-right jump must be hit with your left foot on the up arrow. So that would be the up-right jump. So, dun dun, dun dun dun. So, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. But no matter what, this whole section, make sure that all the jumps are hit with your left foot on the top. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. So left foot on the top. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. And then two jumps with left foot on the top. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2. It looks intimidating, but it really just goes to the music. So just know the music. And this part also looks pretty intimidating because it's suffering from yellow note syndrome. But it's truly not that bad. And you can jump for all these. If you're unsure, just jump. Like, if you didn't know what you were looking at here, you won't get penalized if you do, like, a left-right jump and then, like, a left... an upright jump twice. Like, you can get it. It's not gonna penalize you. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, And then this one, if you can, if you want to set up yourself really nicely for this next section, make sure you hit this freeze with your left foot. I'll be honest, I usually hit enter this freeze with my right foot. But if you do that, you just have to do a quick switch, which we already had to do twice. So if you want to make it thrice, this would be the time. But either way, you want to make sure you're starting with your left foot for this next section. All right. So one, two, and the count is, so 1, 2, 3, 4, so 1, 2, 3, 4, go. So count it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, go. So how the fuck do we do this? We're going to be slowing it down. That's how we're going to do it. So left foot. And then left foot, right foot here. And then right, and then left, left. And then we're going to tippy toe with our right foot. And then use our heel to hit this and the left to hit that with the toes. Okay, then this is just hard, but you gotta do it. It's just like, you know, you wanna like, you know, get the tips and tricks. I'm giving it to you, but some things are just fucking hard, and you just gotta go for it. But here is where we gotta do a foot switch. So we're left foot, and then swing our right foot to the up, and then do this one, and then make sure that you double step that, so that when you're doing this, it's the same as what we just did above. And in fact, this is way easier because we're going to hit this right arrow with our heel, and then I always just do bum bum. So bum 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 bum, you get it? It's pretty easy if you do it right. Whenever you're ready, YouTube, just take your time. No pressure. Okay, where were we? 3. And then try to hit this jump right here. This is like the most tricky part for me because I always hit this with my right foot on the up. Don't be like me. Make sure you hit this with your left foot on the up arrow, because then you can get this pretty nicely. And then double step that. This is not easy. Like, I'm slowing it down. I'm making it like look like it's possible. It's fucking hard, okay? At full speed, it's fucking hard. But you gotta put these mental notes in your head. So once again, double step. Make sure we jump on this with our left foot. And then we're going to push this up. And yes, we're going to do a back cross. But more specifically, now here's a very, very hard thing. I can pull it off like about 30% of the time. So results will vary. But I'll tell you what I do do. The strategy here is we are going to cross this over. So right up, right. Right up, right. So as soon as we hit the right foot here, I'm going to do that thing I told you before where my right foot's here and now my left foot is going to come join it, say hi. So my left foot is now together with my right foot on the left arrow. And then, do you remember that AM3P breakdown I did? Well, yeah, it's kind of just like that, just about like 100 times harder. So we're going to, our left foot is planted here. We are going to bracket jump the down right, which is a very rare bracket jump that I have to make, but this song calls for it twice. So we're going to bracket jump that, and then we're going to jackhammer this with our left, and then we are going to smash this with our left. And now you'll see why you're not going to PFC this with my breakdown, because I will be 100% with you here. At this point, I usually just bracket this next section right here, because I don't have enough time to hit that and then jump into this with my right foot on top. I'm not even sure if I've ever even tried, but if you want to like break it down the way I am, like if after you did what I just told you to, you have to find some way, and this is fast, like you'll have to immediately jump up. All right, yeah, it's just, I don't see it happening. I really don't see it happening. So bracket jump this. And then if you can find a way to do what I can't, what I usually do is I'll just hit this with my left foot on the top, and then I'll just like lazily do this and hit the down, and then try to get the right, and then do it one more time. So I'll hit that, and then I'll lazily do this. And then, as soon as I get here, I'm fine. But, ideally, what you want to do is what I'm trying to tell you. And that is, make sure you get on your right foot. So, if it's easier to remember, the first one you want to be left foot on the top. And the second one you want to be, for the up-downs, you want to be right foot on the top. You gotta do it twice, and then double step that, and do it one more time. And then jump, and then we're going to cross this over, and if it's not patented already, what we're going to do is foot switch. So after our right foot is holding down, our left foot is going to come join the right foot on the left arrow. And I promise you this is a lot easier. This is like AM3P. We're going to bracket jump this with our right foot, and we're going to jackhammer that with our left, and then bracket jump this one more time with our right. Okay, and that's it. So then this one, after this arrow, I jump, because like right now we are facing with the right foot and the left foot is on the left arrow. What I'm going to do is jump over and land on the triplet. So we're going to do holding it, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So holding it, 1, 2, jump, switch it, plant it down with the right arrow first, 1, 2, 3. So that's the pattern we're going for. And then you can double step this. It's not too fast. Hold on, I want to look at it full speed real quick. Yeah, you can double step that, but you have to be a little careful. So make sure you hit these. Whatever you do to lead up to it, make sure that you're getting back in that good position. So our right foot is going to want to be back here again. So our left foot is going to hit these two. And then right foot is going to hit that. And then 1, 2, 3, hit it. And then we're in a perfect position to hit this triplet. And then, so we're in a good position to hit that triplet. And then we're going to foot switch on this. So down, with our left and then foot switch to that. And then, yeah, fucking good luck. Like, if you really wanted some tips here, like, I got no tips. Like, just fucking pray to your deity, okay? Pray to the almighty Chris Chaikin. Maybe he'll throw you a bone or something. I got nothing, okay? These are 16th notes at 190 BPM. And they're jumps, okay? They're fucking jumps. Like, there's really nothing I can tell you that's gonna make it easy. Like, these... This is really not meant to be hit. It's a miracle that people have found ways to get perfects, and I've done it on very, very rare occasions, but, like, there's like, no tips here. Like, it's just, like, you gotta keep low. Like, the only tip is, like, if you want to try to get the most of it, like, try to go early on the first one, then you should be on time for the second one, then you'll be late for that. But whatever you do, if you're just going for the score, you gotta get the freeze, because the freeze is worth a lot more than any of those. So do your best, just keep very low, go as fast as you can, and then make sure you hit that fourth one. So it's a 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1. You might as well just be 4, like, that's so insane. And then we're going to get a 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And then this one's going to get a foot switch. And then try to hit this with your right foot, because it'll be a little bit better. And you have to do it one more time. 1, 2, 3. And then this last one. So this is like the hardest bracket jump we're going to be doing, because we're going to be doing 1, 2, 3, and then left, left, left for the up left bracket jump. And then it's going to be very critical, because... In fact, we're going to do the write downs on freezes. You cannot miss these. You cannot miss these, or your score will be screwed. And then, it's a very awkward position, because you have to quickly reach up with your right foot, and we are going to do this crossover legit. But, so we're going to 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we're in a position where it's not too awkward to change to the upright. And then, you can double step or crossover this. And then this one's actually very nice. This is so much harder on regular turn. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, 6. And then this one is the same as before, but we're going to be doing back crosses, so something there. And then there is enough time to change to a good position to hit that correctly. And then we're going to double step this, so 1, 2, 3. And then I'm going to bracket jump these three. And then make sure you throw your right foot to the bottom here. And then, this is a bit of an awkward thing, but you can usually get it. And you can hit that. And then as soon as you get there, I'm going to be honest, I do bracket this step, but I do see a lot of advantage if you can foot switch to the up arrow here. If you hit this one with your left, you might be a little bit in a better position. But if you're like me, I'm just going to hit this with, and, oh, let me do the count for you. So, it's oops, I missed it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's a 5 count like before. And this listen to it. Like I used to pick up a lot of greats here until I actually like listen to what's going on. So listen very carefully. It's a weird beat. It doesn't really go to the music. So, and I always do a gallop into that. So what I'd like to do is bum 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 bum. I throw in one more here. It's usually an up. Bum 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 bum. And then when I hit this one, so left foot, right, right, but I'll foot switch and then hit that double step. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 and then 1, 2, 3. And then dun 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 dun. And then we're gonna be forced to look here because we're not gonna read that. So, like I said, my strategy is not going to give you a PFC by any means, but it is going to help you maximize your score. So, that actually plays out straightforward. But what you should understand is all this time, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, aren't these like 6th notes, like considering, or technically 12th notes because of the speed, or I think they're 6th notes. Are they 12th notes? I honestly don't know, but I do know that it feels weird. It is weird, and no one likes it. No one likes it. But just visually go for it. You have to visually go for this. And if you're on 1.5, 1.75, or even 2x, I can even read it on 2x. And then just this is how we're going to maximize our points. The first one goes to the left, and then I didn't like that. So the first one's going to be our left foot triplet, right foot triplet, left foot triplet, right foot, and we're going to, now this is where we're going to have to bracket. So we are going to start with our left, right, left, and then we're going to go heel with this one, followed by toe with this one, and then we're going to go toe with our right foot for this one, and then toe with our right foot with this one, and right heel for this one, right toe, right heel, and then we're going to go left, and then right heel, right toe, and then this is the hardest, and this is why you usually can never full combo it. We're going to go left toe to left heel. So that is how I personally do the ending, and that's if I can actually even do it, but ideally that's how I am going for it. And then as soon as we're done, we're going back to the bracket jumps. So play it out. I can't even remember the jump sequence, but luckily I don't have to. So I just know that it's going to be 1, 2, 3, and then left foot, this will play out. But, and then we're going to bracket jump out one more time, and then just a down left, up right, which I'll bracket jump, and then I'll hit it. And whenever I'm in doubt at the very end, I just jump for all of, I just jump for all of them. Just 1, 2, 3. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, and that does it. Okay, hopefully that was under an hour. But there you go. The long-awaited Dead End Groove Radar Special Challenge has been broken down by Dr. D on left, requested by Quickman. If you guys want to say Quickman, no. Requested by Piguy314159. And I'm not going to go any further because I will show you how little of Pi I actually know. So, there you go. I hope you guys found it enjoyable. I hope that this is going to be your video that helps you get your score increase. And if it does, let me know in the comments. If you used any of my tips to help you improve your score, I'd love to know that. Write the comments down below, and I'll be looking forward to going there. Again, keep in mind, all the PFCs except for one on this song have been done on shuffle. So if you really want to optimize your score, maybe consider using shuffle. But you can absolutely get in the 980s. I would say that the strategy can even get you in the AAA if you're more physically fit than I am. All right, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll see you guys next time, and peace.
Hey guys, thanks for watching this video. Be sure to leave a like and a comment down below. If you like what I do and want to be notified whenever I upload or go live, subscribe and hit that bell icon. If you really love me, consider pledging on Patreon to enjoy exclusive benefits. Lastly, keep the DDR discussion going by joining my Discord community, linked below. Thanks again, and peace.